So, this is Michael Anderson from the ITDF YouTube channels from Mississauga, just outside Toronto, and here with the winner of the men's singles or boys singles, Andreas Levenko. And Andreas, you had some issues in the final. You were up 2-0 and then dropped down to 3-2, but you kept your cool and worked hard.
It was not easy to stay calm at this situation, but I knew that if I will not calm down, I will have no chance to win this, and so I was I calmed down, then I was really relaxed, so I had no stress, and then I just played very smoothly.
And really a huge victory for you, you as a player. It's not easy to win this kind of qualification tournaments. A lot of people, players are wanting it really hard, and you came out, you told me before, you came out with a little bit more of a relaxed attitude this time.
I was at the beginning from tournament, I was really calm, but I didn't expect that I will win this tournament, and really happy to win this.
And now, road to Nanjing, that means that you're going to Youth Olympic Games, and it must be a tremendous feeling right now to stand here.
Yeah, sure, it's a really great feeling, and I'm very happy that I can go to Nanjing and that I won this tournament, and yeah.
And you told me before, you were quite happy with your coach also here. He kept coming in here, accompanying you on the trip, David Vorcnik. First time coaching you in competition?
Yeah, for sure. My coach is a really important active part at this tournament, because it was a really good coaching, and it's also a friendship, so this is very important. And then it was, the coach was really, I'm really satisfied this time, and yeah.
So we turn to the coach, David Vorcnik, player in the Austrian League, playing against Andreas many times in practice at BSA, and as a start of a coaching career, this is pretty good.
That's quite nice. I mean, my activity is not over, so I don't know. Maybe I will stop with table tennis, with the playing, and start coaching. But yeah, I don't know.
And in your views, what did he do good in this competition that you normally have seen him not do so good? Was there any difference from before in your opinion?
Yeah, he was very calm. I mean, normally when the things go wrong, he's a little bit loud and nervous a little bit, but in this situation, when he was 3-2 and 0-4 down, he was really calm in this situation. So congratulations to him, yeah.
And the timeout there, I think, was 3-0 in the sixth game. It was quite critical. And what was said in that particular timeout?
Yeah, that he should calm down. And yeah. I said to him, okay, this tactic is not the best now. So I said to him, okay, let's change the tactic a little bit and let's see what will happen.
And I thought it would be battle all the way to the end in the seventh game. But quickly, you know, you got a feeling, and maybe also you on the bench feeling that Alander was going down a little bit. He played a tough number of matches here, you know, 4-3 all the way. So did you get the same feeling?
Yeah, I mean, when you're, yeah, of course, but Arlanda in this tournament, he was out in the first round or second round, I don't know, but so I thought that, Andre should be focused more, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and certainly with the two happy Austrians here, congratulations, you're going to Nanjing. Hopefully both of you. Okay, let's see about that. There's a decision for the Austrian Association to make in this particular situation. So congratulations, and over and out from the Road to Nanjing series in Mississauga, Toronto. Thank you.